Hello everyone, welcome you to my channel. In this video, you are going to know about Photoshop. When Photoshop was first created, how it was created, who was created and many more interesting facts. So, let's find out all the interesting informations about Photoshop without any delay. Photoshop. Photoshop CS. Photoshop CC. This is how Photoshop was named from then to now. Adobe Photoshop is a raster graphics editor developed and published by Adobe Systems for macOS and Windows. The very first version of Photoshop was released in January 1988, but was not publicly released. This demo was the first known copy of Photoshop with any public exposure. Then first version of Photoshop distributed commercially, by the scanner company Barney Scan, though distributed as Barney Scan XP. Let me start from the very beginning of the invention of Photoshop. At present we know that Photoshop is a product of Adobe. But who made this program? The Photoshop was created in 1988 by Thomas and John Knoll. Since then, it has become the de facto industry standard in raster graphics editing. It was developed in 1987 by the American brothers Thomas and John Knoll, who sold the distribution license to Adobe Systems Incorporated in 1988. Thomas Knoll, a PhD student at the University of Michigan, and his brother John Knoll, an industrial light and magic employee, was developed it. Or you can say they invent the first program for photo editing or like so. Thomas Knoll was writing a program on his Macintosh Plus to display grayscale images on a monochrome display. This program, called Display, caught the attention of his brother John Knoll, who recommended that Thomas turn it into a full-fledged image editing program. Then both brothers collaborated each others and finally they coded it and able to made the first photo editing software. Then they worked out a short-term deal with scanner manufacturer Barney Scan to distribute copies of the program with a slide scanner. A total of about 200 copies of Photoshop were shipped this way. During that time, John traveled to Silicon Valley and gave a demonstration of the program to engineers at Apple and Russell Brown, art director at Adobe. Both showings were successful, and Adobe decided to purchase the license to distribute in September 1988. Fun fact, the first Photoshopped image was of John's wife, on the beach, taken from a trip to the Hawai'ian Islands. John named the image file, Jennifer in Paradise. So, Jennifer in Paradise became the first color image used to demonstrate the software they had started to call Photoshop, and you also can say this was the first tutorial on Photoshop. Interesting, isn't it? Photoshop 1 was released on the 19th of February 1990 for Macintosh exclusively. Photoshop's naming scheme was initially based on version numbers. Adobe published 13 versions before the October 2003 introduction of Creative Suite branding. In February 2013, Adobe donated the source code of the 1991.0.1 version of Photoshop to the Computer History Museum. Those versions were sold particularly who had the Creative Suite subscription. Then Adobe introduced with the Creative Cloud, where Photoshop is being sold with other Adobe products like Illustrator, Audition, InDesign and many more. They released 5 major upgrades of Photoshop CC till now. With every upgrade, Adobe developed a lot of features in Photoshop, and year by year it turns into a powerful software for editing raster-based images and so on. It can edit and compose raster images in multiple layers and supports masks, alpha compositing and several color models including RGB, CMYK, spot color and duotone. Photoshop has vast support for graphic file formats but also uses its own PSD and PSB file formats which support all the aforementioned features. In addition to raster graphics, it has limited abilities to edit or render text, vector graphics especially through clipping path, 3D graphics and video. Photoshop's feature set can be expanded by Photoshop plugins, programs developed and distributed independently of Photoshop that can run inside it, and offer new or enhanced features. Adobe creates some plugins, such as Adobe Camera Raw, but third-party companies develop most plugins, such as Alien Skin Software, Nix Software, On One Software, Topaz Labs Software, the plugin site, AutoFX Software, AV Brothers, Flaming Pear Software, etc. Now let know some interesting facts altogether about Photoshop. The tale began in 1987 when PhD student Thomas Knoll wrote a graphics application in a Macintosh Plus. The software was used to display grayscale images on a monochrome display. Knoll called it Display. We could now consider Display as the unofficial father of our beloved Photoshop. On September 1989, everything changed for Photoshop when Adobe bought it. A year after, on February 1, 1990, Photoshop 1.0 was released. It included digital color editing and retouching. It was dedicated for use in high-end platforms such as the Cytex, and costs $300 for basic photo retouching. Adobe Photoshop runs in 26 languages: English, Arabic, Chinese, French, German, and so on. Photoshop's CC version includes various changes. With CC, you are granted with more liberty, speed, and make images incredibly real. Looking back into Photoshop, we will see how a simple idea can evolve into a useful and impacting tool. Without the Knoll's display, we would not have our favorite software, right? And the future? Unsurprisingly, Adobe isn't telling. Photoshop is the jewel in its crown and its development is closely guarded. Rumors that Illustrator will merge with Photoshop have also abounded for years. Whatever happens, it's likely that Thomas Knoll will be involved in some way. Although not directly concerned with Photoshop these days, he still keeps his hand in, recently developing the Adobe Camera Raw plugin and posting occasionally to the Adobe forums. And that's all for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe this channel. Ring the bell so that every time when I upload a video or a tutorial, you won't miss any of them. Thank you for watching this video. I will back with our usual Photoshop tutorials. Till then, stay safe, stay passionate. Goodbye.